Welcome to the next lecture in electrical machines. We are going to discuss here the function of commutator. So our discussion will focus on commutator. Before that, let us see with the help of a simple loop generator how the commutator functions. So consider only one coil placed in a strong magnetic field. So this is the direction of the magnetic field. And there is a coil which is placed in the magnetic field. So here you have a rectangular shaped coil which is placed in the magnetic field. The two ends of the coil are joined to a slip rings. So here you can see two slip rings are there through which the two ends of the coils are connected, and two brushes are there which is resting on this slip ring. So you have two brushes which is resting on the slip rings. Then the EMF that is produced, due to the rotation of the conductor in the magnetic field will be an alternating current. So here at 180 degree, if you see, the EMF will have the positive direction from 0 to 180 degree, and from 180 degree to 360 degree, it will have a negative direction. So this will be negative and this will be positive. So at theta 90 degree, you will be having the maximum EMF, and theta minus 90 or 270 degree, you will be having an EMF which is at minus of negative max. Now, when coil is rotated in counterclockwise direction at an angular velocity of omega radian per second, then flux is cut by the coil and EMF is induced in it. This is in accordance with the Faraday's law. We see that when the coil will be rotated, so this coil is basically rotating in the anticlockwise direction, so it is cutting the flux, hence the EMF is produced in the coil. The induced EMF is alternating, and the current flowing through the external resistance is also alternating. So the whatever the EMF is generated here, that is AC MMF, this is also alternating in the external circuit. That is, at second instant, the current flows in an external resistance from M to L, whereas the fourth instant it will flow from L to M. So here you can see that M to L you have, then in the second instant it will flow from M to L, and in the fourth instant it will flow from L to M, and you will be getting an AC voltage both in the internal as well as external of the circuit. Now the role of commutator will come. So what is the commutator action we have? Now consider that the two ends of the coil are connected to only one slip ring, which is splitted into two part segment A dash and B dash. So earlier we were having two slip rings. Now we will be using only one slip ring, and it is splitted into two parts. So here you can see that A double dash and B double dash are splitted up to form two segments of the slip rings, and each part is insulated from the other by a mica layer. So this we have seen when we have seen the commutator picture, that there is a mica insulation between the two segments. So two brushes are resting on these parts of the ring. So obviously there will be two brushes here and here. So these brushes will be used to tap the EMF. So you can see that in this case, you are not having an AC, rather you are having a unidirectional EMF. So in this case, you are having a unidirectional EMF. We don't have the negative sign. So at 180 degree, you are getting in the positive direction only. Okay. So this is what the commutator is playing a action. So in this case, when the coil is rotated in counterclockwise direction at an angular speed of omega, the flux is cut and EMF is induced. However, the EMF induced in the coil at various instant will remain the same. So here we are getting an unidirectional EMF. However, the flow of the current in the external resistor or circuit will become unidirectional. So we are getting an unidirectional current at the flow, and that is at second instant, the flow of current in the external resistor is from M to L, as well as the flow of the current in the external resistor is M to L in the fourth instant. So we are not changing the direction of the current. In the earlier, you are having from M to L and L to M. Now in this case, in all instant, we are having from M to L. So you are getting an unidirectional current flow. So AC is converted into unidirectional current in the external circuit with the help of a split ring, and that is a commutator. So we are not using two slip rings, we are using one slip ring which is splitted into two parts, and that is a commutator which is helping the AC to convert into unidirectional current in the external circuit. In actual machine, there are number of coils that is connected to the number of segment of the ring called a commutator. So we have taken an example with one coil. However, when you go with actual machine, you will be finding the number of coils will be there, and there will be number of segments of the ring called the commutator. So the EMF or current delivered by this coil to the external load will be in DC. So the actual flow of current flowing in the external load is shown by the firm line, which fluctuates slightly. So if you see that this is the actual EMF that we are getting, but shown by the solid line, and then this solid line will give you an induced EMF, which is a DC quantity. Okay, so the number of coils placed in the armature is even much more than this, and a pure DC is obtained at the output. So you are obtaining a pure DC at the output, whereas the AC is produced inside the DC machine. Thus, in actual machine working as a generator, the function of commutator is to convert the AC current produced in the armature into direct current in the external circuit. So this is the basic function of the commutator. You are converting an alternating current into a direct current in the external circuit. Now, how do we connect the armature coils and commutator segment, and what are the location of brushes that we are going to discuss? So here we have taken an example where the coils and commutator segments are shown and its electrical connections are shown. So if you consider an armature with four coils, now we have taken an example with four coils, 1 to 4, which are equally spaced in the slots. So armature will have coils. So coil number 1 is here, and coil number 2 is here, you have a coil number 3 and coil number 4. So these are placed in the slots of the armature, and you have an opposite polarity. So this is 1, so it will be having 1 dash. So if you have 2, then it is will be having 2 dash. So here you have 3, here you have 3, so it is 3 dash, and you are having 4 dash here. So the number of commutator segment is equal to the number of coils. So the total number of coils will be equal to the number of commutator segment. So when an armature is rotated in the clockwise direction of induced EMF, and hence the current in coil sides, then 3 dash, 1, 4 dash and 2 is downward. So if you split the armature into two equal halves, then you will see that the current that is flowing in the coil side, so if you have 3 dash, 1 or 4 dash and 2, the current will be in the downward direction, whereas if you take 1 dash, 3, 2 dash and 4, the current will be in the upward direction. So this will be the direction of the current in the two parts of the conductor which are present in the slots, and the electrical connections are shown. So through the brushes, the current is being tapped to have the positive and negative. Okay, so let us consider that for a two pole, four coil, four segment DC machine. So number of coils will be equal to number of segments. So we can see the commutator segment here, 1, 2, 3 and 4. And basically we are having four coils we have, and these are the coil sides that are being shown. So the coils should be connected in such a way that the EMF induced in the two sides of the same coil be added up. So the connection of coils should be in such a way that when we are taking the two sides of the same coil, you see it is adding up. The coil side, if you take 1 and 4 dash, so you can see the coil side 1 and coil side 4 dash. If you take the coil side 1 dash and 2, so it is coil side 1 dash and 2, and 2 dash and 3, so this is the coil side 2 dash and 3. If you have coil side 3 dash and 4, these are connected in the commutator segment, namely 1, 2, 3 and 4. So 1 and 4 are connected in the commutator segment 1, 1 dash and 2 is connected to the commutator segment 2, 2 dash and 3 dash is connected in the commutator segment 3, and 4 and 3 dash are connected in the commutator segment 4. So the next point of discussion is to determine how many brush sets are required and where these are to be placed with respect to the poles. So how many brush is basically required that we are going to discuss. So the brushes are to collect or deliver the current. So either the brushes is collecting the current or delivering the current depending upon whether it is a generator or a motor, and is placed in such a way that the position that sparking is minimum. So we know that there will be sparking because of the friction, so sparking has to be minimum at the brushes. The rules to be followed for determining the position of the brushes we are going to discuss now. So first rule is place the brush at each meeting point or each separating point of the two EMFs. So we have to place the brush in such a way that it is either at the meeting point or at the separating point. Then the brushes at the meeting point are of positive polarity, whereas those separating point are of negative polarity. So if you see here, this is having a positive polarity plus, and here you have a negative polarity of the brushes. So the meeting point, where is the meeting point, you will be having a positive polarity, and where you have a separating point, you will be having a negative polarity. Then at segment 1, if you consider a segment 1, it is current is separated. So current is separated two ways. So here the current separation is there at segment 1 towards conductor 1 and 4 dash. So you have a towards conductor 1 and 4 dash. Hence it is a separating point, and then you have a negative point here. So on the other hand, if you consider the segment 3, so here you can see that the two current are basically entering here. So if this is considered as positive for the, because it is the meeting point of the two current. The commutator segment 1 is the position of negative brush. So here you have the position of the negative brush, and commutator 3 is the position of the positive brush. Now second point to be considered is brushes are generally equally spaced and placed directly opposite to the pole centers. So the first we have discussed how it is meeting and separating. The second we will be discussing that how brushes are generally equally spaced. So this brings out a very important point, namely that in certain positions of the commutator, the brushes will be equally short-circuiting the coils connected to the segment with which they are in contact. So basically, if you have the commutator segment and you are connecting a brush, it will be short-circuiting the segment coils to which when the AC is converting to DC supply. So in this case, the two coils are short-circuited. So basically, two coils are short-circuited, and such that the width of the brush much be greater than the thickness of the mica insulation between the segment. So when AC is converted to DC in the commutator, there will be short-circuiting of the two coils, and in such, the width of the brushes much be greater than the thickness of the mica insulation. So for representation, the general convention is to place the brush at geometric neutral plane. So geometric neutral plane is the plane where you have the both north plane, north pole and south pole, and here this is the geometric neutral plane. Now conductors above the brush axis carry current in one direction, and the conductors below the brush axis will carry the current in the opposite direction. So in the first we have discussed how the current was meeting and leaving. So here we will be discussing that when conductors which is placing above the brush axis will carry current in one direction, whereas the conductors which are below the brush will be in the opposite direction. The convention represents that the brushes are placed at the coil or coils in which the voltage induced is zero. So where the voltage induced is zero, there only the brush will be placed. So here we will be seeing how the actual position of the brushes and how the position of the coil sides are there in this. So we and 2 and 4 are undergoing commutation. So if you see the commutator segment 2 and commutator segment 4, since it is rotating, so this 2 will be coming under the influence of this brush and 4 will be coming under the influence of this brush. So the 2 and 4 will be short circuited, and then the current will be tapped to be DC here. So that is the actual position of the brush. So we can see that in this case, when 2 and 4 are basically undergoing the commutation, what will happen? So here you have two conductor number 2 and conductor number 4 are undergoing the commutation, and the current is being tapped from the brushes. So what are the position of the other segments and how the conductors are being placed throughout the commutator segments? So the negative brush short circuit the segment 1. So here you have the negative brush, so it will be short circuiting the segment 1, whereas 1 and 4, and the positive brush will be short circuiting the segment 2 and 3. So the coils 4 and 2 are short circuited by the brush. So if you see the coil number 2 and coil number 4 are basically short circuited by the brush, and no EMF was induced in these coils. So the armature winding will form a closed circuit and consist of two parallel paths. So in that case, when coil number 2 and coil number 4 are short circuited by the brushes or the commutator segment, then it forms a closed circuit and two parallel paths are formed, and the coil undergoes commutation, no EMF is induced since it passes through the MNA axis. So here you have the geometric neutral plane, and when the conductor, this is your GNA axis, and when this armature is rotating and you have the brush here, so this is your MNA axis. So here you have the MNA axis. Okay, so the coil, when undergoes commutation, no EMF is induced since it is passing through the MNA, so the conductor is passing through the MNA axis, and the coil is short circuited by the brushes, so no sparking is produced because the EMF produces zero. So in this way, we have discussed the importance of a commutator in a DC machine and how the commutator is converting the AC to DC, and with the help of the commutator segment and the location of the brushes. So this was an important discussion in case of the DC machine. Thank you for now.